It was somewhere in September, and the sun was going down, when I came in search of coffee to a darling river town. Come and have a drink, we'll call it, 'tis a fitting name, I think, and was raining for a wonder, up and come and have a drink. Underneath the pub veranda, I was resting on a bunk, when a stranger rose before me, and he said that he was drunk. He apologized for speaking, there was no offense, he swore, but he somehow seemed to fancy that he'd seen my face before. He agreed you can't remember all the chaps you chanced to meet, and he said his name was Sweeney, people lived in Sussex Street. He was camping in a stable, but he swore that he was right, only for the blanky horses walking over him all night. He'd apparently been fighting, for his face was black and blue, and it looked as though the horses had been treading on him too. But an honest, genial twinkle in the eye that wasn't hurt seemed to hint of something better, spite of drink and rags and dirt. He was born in Parramatta, and he said with humor grim that he'd like to see the city ere the liquor finished him. But he couldn't raise the money, he was darned if he could think what the government was doing here. He offered me a drink. I declined with self-denial, and I lectured him on booze, using all the hackneyed arguments that preachers mostly use. Things I'd heard in temperance lectures, I was young and rather green, and I ended by referring to the man he might have been. But he couldn't stay to argue, for his beer was nearly gone. He was glad, he said, to meet me, and he'd see me later on. But he guessed he'd have to go and get his bottle filled again, and he gave a lurch and vanished in the darkness and the rain. And of afternoons in cities, when the rain is on the land, visions come to me of Sweeney with his bottle